In this video, we're going to talk about a cable problem in which there are two types of forces, a variable force and a constant force. So, find the work done winding 10 feet of a 25-foot cable that weighs 4 pounds per foot when there's a 50-pound mass that hangs on the end. Okay, so I'm going to draw the picture first. Okay, so we're going to be winding down 25 feet of rope, and we're going to be winding, well, actually 10 feet of a 25-foot cable. Okay, and there's also a mass attached at the very end. So the shape of this mass can be anything, so we'll just label it as a block. It will not change its weight. So we'll indicate this, that this is 50 pounds. Okay. So when I said that there's a variable force involved, you should understand the variable force will be associated with the cable itself, right? Because the more you pull, the less force that you will require for the remaining amount of cable. Okay, so the longer the cable, the more force you will need, because it will weigh more, right? Because the less cable you have to pull, the less it will weigh, the less force you will need to pull it. But the constant force is associated with this mass attached at the very end, because no matter how far you get, no matter how much you pull, no matter the length of the cable that you pull up, this mass is still at the end and you will still need the same force to keep pulling it. Okay, so let's break this up. I'm not going to use summation, because summation is going to be a little bit confusing here. I will rather use a straightforward method to find the work done. Okay, so we know that the work is usually estimated as an integral from A to B, and inside the integral, in the integrand, there's going to be a function for the force. Okay, some type of function, the force function. So we're going to indicate it as f of y dy. Okay, so we need to find the f of y. But notice that there are two types of forces. There's a variable force and a constant force. So we will need to add these two forces to give us this resulting f of y in the integrand. Okay, so let's find these two forces. So first we're going to find the force associated with the cable. Okay, and this will be as a function of y. Okay, so notice that we can determine this, we can use this distance, which is 25 feet, because that's the cable length, it's a 25-foot cable. So we can label it as 25 feet. And notice that you can break this up. You can break this length of 25 feet into little parts. You can break it into a distance of y, and you can break the rest of this distance as the distance of 25 minus y. Okay? And this is where the variable force comes into play. Because as we mentioned earlier, the more you pull, the less force you will need, right? So with each foot of cable being pulled up, the less force you will need to pull the remaining amount of the cable. Okay, so in other words, once you pull y feet of cable, you will have 25 minus y feet of cable to be pulled up. So we can use the conversion factor here, the 4 pounds per foot. Okay, 4 pounds per foot, and multiply it with 25 minus y feet, right? Because we don't know essentially what y is, but it will help us estimate the variable force, right? So it's going to be 25 minus y feet. Okay, that's the distance. We cannot use just 25 because the force is not constant when we're associating it with the cable. We have to include the variable 25 minus y. And again, we don't know what y is. Y can be any number. It's arbitrary. But we know that essentially the force will vary depending on the y, depending on how much we have already pulled. Okay? So we multiply the 4 pounds per foot, the conversion factor, by the 25 minus y feet, and that will give us the function for the force for the cable. Okay, so it's going to be 4 times 25 minus y pounds. Because note how feet are conveniently canceled out, and you're left with pounds. And that's exactly what force should be. So that's the force function for the cable. Now the force function for the mass as a function of y will be simply 50 pounds. And why is it 50 pounds? Because this is the weight of this object attached to the very end of the rope, at the very end of the rope. And this object will weigh the same no matter how far you pull it up, right? So you will always need the same force that will counter its weight, which is also going to be 50 pounds. So that's why the force function is constant in this case. Okay, because no matter how much you pull, you will always have to use the same force of 50 pounds. So basically, the work done of pulling, winding 10 feet of this 25-foot cable is going to include these two forces added together in the integral. Okay, so we're going to indicate it as work subscript cable plus mass is going to be the definite integral, and the limits of integration are going to be from 0 to 10. Okay, because you're winding 10 feet. Okay, 10 feet, and you're starting from 0 because you're starting from the complete length of 25 feet of cable. Okay, and you're pulling up from 0. So 0 to 10 are your limits of integration. And once again, you're going to sum up the forces, the constant and the variable forces, to give you the resulting force that you're going to put in the integral. So it's going to be force of cable as a function of y, the distance pulled, plus the force of the mass, also as a function of y. Okay, and then simply dy at the end. And then it's going to give you, we're going to substitute in the numbers that we know. So the force of cable was 4 times 25 minus y. And then we're adding the constant force, which is 50. Okay. And then taking the thickness dy there. And I'm just going to simplify that. And that turns into 100 plus 50, that's 150, minus 4y dy. And now it's relatively simple. Now we can ignore the zero when we're evaluating the definite integral. We can just worry about the upper limit. So it's going to be 150 multiplied by 10. And then y will have a square to it when we integrate. So also dividing it by 2, so we're going to have the coefficient of minus 2, and then y squared, taking the 10th of the y, will give us 10 squared. Okay, so that's simply going to give you 1500. Sorry, I should make it a little better. 1500 minus 200, right? And that's going to give you 1300 foot-pounds. Now remember that the force is in pounds, and the distance is in feet. And forces, work is calculated by multiplying the force and the distance. Okay, since we already found the force functions, we can just simply use this formula, okay, in which the dy will be the distance and the force is going to be the function. Okay, and once again, we didn't need summation because we just found the force functions using this definition here, this formula, the basic formula for the work done using the force. And we've calculated the total work required lifting, winding 10 feet of a 25-foot cable that weighs 4 pounds per foot, when there's also a 50-pound mass that hangs on the end. I hope this was a helpful tutorial for this particular problem. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in my next video.